Hello there, creative friends, and happy 2020 with the start of the new decade. I have been doing a little retrospective of this big box I have of all my art journals and sketchbooks and writing journals from the last almost a decade, for about 9 years. I'm also preparing for the people that are coming into my new program this year called In Spirit. And part of that is about helping them decide what supplies are going to be best for their creative practice during that program and as we experiment throughout the year with our different supplies and things. And so I thought it might be fun to make just a few clips on what I've gleaned from my mixed media creative practice using all kinds of different sorts of art journals and sketchbooks and notebooks. I wanted to begin with spiral books. What I kind of discovered as I was going through all these different styles of art journals and sketchbooks is how I really have a preference for the different kinds for different reasons. And I bet some of you can relate to that, or perhaps you're just starting your creative practice and you're not even sure where to begin. And if that's the case, I want to encourage you to kind of experiment and just play around and listen to a few of my tips here. You might be able to recognize what might be like your tendency. If I had to come and choose just one type of art journal or sketchbook for my everyday creative process, practice, sketching, capturing ideas, capturing synchronicities, insights, connections, all the things, I would probably choose a spiral bound. Now, I do have some things I don't like about the spiral bound, but the spiral bound in general, what I love about them is that they're relatively affordable. You can get them in all sorts of different sizes with different papers, and they really easily flip like this. So if you're going a little bit larger, which is when I generally prefer spiral bound, they're perfect because you're not dealing with like a 9x12, like this one here. All of a sudden it becomes an 18x12, you know, like this. That's really big in a hard bound kind of journal, and it's kind of awkward to hold. But if you can flip that baby around, it makes a really nice surface, and they usually come with some sort of chipboard or hard back. And so they're really great if you're outdoors, if you're traveling, if you're just sitting and you don't have a table, you can pull them out and use them easily on your lap. Also, they're not as precious. And that is what makes me more apt to use them, to try things, to experiment in my creative practice. These ones right here are the Strathmore series. So this series, I believe, is still around. This little one here is the Visual Journal Strathmore series with a watercolor 140-pound paper. And I have had a few of these over the years, and I wanted to bring the blank one to show you. It has a real tooth to it. It's really nice. If you like that toothiness, they're very thick pages, so they take mixed media beautifully. But because they're so thick, you're not going to get, oh, there is something in there. You're not going to get quite as many pages out of a notebook as you might with something that's a little bit thinner of paper, which is just fine. This one is a Strathmore series as well. But what I noticed about the difference, and I redid my cover here. I don't believe this is the watercolor paper, at least not at the 140 pound, because it's much smoother. But I do believe it is a mixed media paper of some sort. So Strathmore makes a quality product for sure. It's really nice for mixed media. Everything holds up really well, even when I get kind of wet. Or if I get moving into layers. So the Strathmore series with these firm backs and those brown covers are real good. They're not my favorite though. The ones that I do choose for my everyday spiral sketchbooks, I just seem to keep coming back to these again and again, is the Canson mixed media. And I'll tell you a few reasons why I happen to like them. They're 98 pounds, they're a bit thicker, but they're not as thick as watercolor paper. And yet, they hold up well to mixed media. You will, if you leave something open to dry, you will get some buckling, but once you close that baby up and you carry it around and it stays flat, those things flatten out really beautifully. I also love that they come in so many sizes. This is the 5.5 by 8.5. There's a 7x10 that's one of my favorites. And then there's this, of course, the 9x12 size. This is a little bulkier. When I'm choosing these sizes, this isn't one that is easy for me to put in my bag if I'm traveling around with it, but the smaller sizes might be, right? Now, the thing about moving a spiral-bound sketchbook in and out of a bag or a backpack that you want to be wary of is that because sometimes these spirals can get kind of warped or smushed or catch on things, and you may not like that. you know, or it may not work for the bag that you're using. 9x12 size though. What I love about this is if I want a really large spread, I do have it, but honestly, most of the time with a 9x12, I'm using just the one page. If I happen to get something that I really love and want to pull out of here, these pages are perforated. It's one of the things that I love about it. You can gesso the pages if you want them to be a little thicker to start. Great size to work out ideas, especially if you do happen to paint a little bit larger. And then of course you can paint those funny little turquoise covers if you want. And that's what I did with this one, which is my new Canson Mixed Media Soul Language visual journal that I will be using for my program In Spirit this year. Now, I have enjoyed making my own spiral bound books too. I have something called the Cinch. I went ahead and invested in it and got the spirals that go with it and have not regretted it. I have made journals to give to people. I have sold journals this way, and I have taken old paintings and things and made myself some journals like this one. This one I made specifically for a 28-day creative practice. And I took a bunch of paintings and some papers and things cut out from different books and made kind of a junk journal out of it. And then I went back in and added things to each page. But I used that spiral binder to bind my own journal. And then I came back in and used those pages that were, some of them were palette pages, some of them were blank, some of them I just collaged over top of, some of them were prints of other paintings of mine, written things, rice paper, all that. Put in an assortment of things and then came in and see what I could turn that into in my creative practice. It's a space to come and just be and let the imagery or the words that come up or that have jumped into my life, you know, hold space for me. So if that's something you might be interested in, you might think about investing in something like the Cinch, for instance. I did bring a couple more here to show you. This one I made a flip through of, and this was a really cheap sketchbook, you guys. I got the sketchbook for $3, right? So the paper is like a student, like, you know, like elementary student grade. There's nothing that great about it. And so I decided to use this sketchbook as a place to tape in or paste in all of these different loose sketches and ideas that I had kind of laying around the studio. So sometimes you can use just a spiral sketchbook to paste or tape in your own loose drawings and remnants from your creative practice as well. As I was looking for through my spiral bound books, I realized I have this one that I've never used, but I've heard wonderful things about Pentalic. And this was actually a gift to me that I forgot that I had a couple years ago. And so I'm happy to have rediscovered it. Maybe some of you, do you have experience with Pentalic? I would love to hear. This is a wire bound watercolor field book. Again, really kind of thick paper. It's toothy. It's going to be wonderful for mixed media or using watercolor out in the field. And then this is another one that was kind of a homemade idea. I'm not actually sure where they got it done, but this was a gift from my niece. And this is her artwork on the cover. Isn't that sweet as can be? And I think they had it spiral bound somewhere. It's actually like somewhere between drawing paper and copy paper, to be honest. It's a little bit smoother than I usually use in mixed media. But what I will say about this is it's wonderful for drawing, certain drawing tools, if you're into that, great for marker. And also for little images like this, where I'm not using a ton of wet media, but maybe I'm using a drier, thicker sort of heavy body, or this is gouache, I believe. So getting out some energetic sort of gesture or shape abstractions onto the page. That's what that kind of paper or any old sketchbook really can be great for if you're not going to soak the whole thing, but you want to play with color or an idea or a composition.